Now that we know how failures come to be, let's look into how to systematically find their causes. What we need is a way to organize the debugging process. And for this, we use a process called the scientific method. That's a cool name, isn't it? It's actually a big name for a little thing, but this little thing, again, has big consequences. What the scientific method does is it provides a systematic process by turning some aspect of reality into a theory that explains how this aspect of reality works and that makes exact predictions on this reality. Let me come up with a simple example of how the scientific method works. Suppose you're a human, say Isaac Newton. You're laying in your orchard and all of a sudden you're watching an apple fall down. So now you wonder, well, I've just seen this apple falling. This is an aspect of reality. Why do apples fall down? What the scientific method does is it provides you a way to come up with the most general prediction method available. So you could think that if an apple falls, and you can repeat this experiment over and over by letting an apple fall, you may also think about, well, do bricks fall? Here's a brick, and lo and behold, it falls. Do plates fall? Oh yes, they do. Do cups fall down too? Oh yes, they do. Put yourself in the mind of a three-year-old, and you will find that everything falls down. And everything really means everything. So you can easily generalize that to everything falls down. Unless you happen to see, say, a balloon. Here's the balloon, and lo and behold, the balloon goes up. So not everything falls down. But you can easily extend your theory to say, well, a balloon is lighter than air. If the air falls down, then the balloon must go up. So still everything falls down. What does down actually mean? Down means towards the center of the Earth. Everything is attracted towards the center of the Earth. Well, the Sun is not attracted to the center of the Earth. It's rather the other way around. So you see that from these observations and even experiments that you can conduct, you will eventually be able to come up with a full-fledged theory that explains where things will be moving, that explains at which velocity they will be moving, which explains what the acceleration will be. And this, in the case of Isaac Newton, then became the theory of gravitation.